give the perspective from the road. So we're kind of right smack dab in the middle of a residential area. And this is King Road, which cuts right across Hong Kong Island.
It's very interesting. I think people will find this interesting because most schools in America are so different. Now, some schools in California are campus-based and they're different, but most Midwest schools, they're a building, one building. Four stories tall, and that's the whole school. So this, just to wrap your mind around the way this is embedded in the community.
Yeah, it is.
I think there's all kinds of great opportunities that way, too. Yeah. I just can't imagine what they are. How do you embrace the community, get the community to embrace you, you know? Is that a lunch area down there?
Yes, it is, and just a recess break. Kids hang out there with their laptops. And you can't really see through, but right through those buildings, not too far, would be the harbor.
Well, I hear there's a restaurant and the hotel I'm in where I can see the harbor.
Yeah. Right up
on
the very top.
Check that out. That's really cool. Are these just retaining walls?
Nope. This used to be a small house here, and they just ripped the house down, and now they're gonna, I suspect, down to about 60 floors.
Wow. Space is at a premium.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you, Jenny. I don't want to get locked out. Yeah, we'll head back to the high school now.
Where are you from originally?
Canada, Nova Scotia.
Really?
This is year 15.
Wow. First came, you were teaching fourth grade.
Yeah, fourth grade.
Here.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
And then
how did you transition from the classroom to IT?
First I moved into head teacher. And then we started to have an explosion about 2000. Like, we really wanted to push forward with IT. So that's when the IT department developed. And the theory was that in order for the technology to fit into the classroom, the leader of it should be a teacher.
Mm-hmm. That's a good theory. I like that theory.
So I've always been the one that I've been taking the tools. Mm-hmm. And this year we were lucky enough for the first time to bring on two more teachers into the department to help other teachers learn how to use the tools.
Okay, so integration, new classroom embedded integration.
Yep.
Come in and kind of hold their hand the first couple times.
Or one of my specialists go into one class so we can pull the teacher out. Because all of our teachers team teach.
That's cool.
So although the school kind of looks small from the outside, once you get into it, there's quite a few spaces. And our high school, you can't see it here, but you can kind of see the corner here. It will tuck down the whole front of these buildings as well, right down to the other road. So it's a longer building.
Do you ever hear sounds above from apartments
sometimes,
above?
Yeah, especially during renovation. My office used to be up here on the fifth floor, and it's on the other side of my wall was the kitchen, so I could smell when they were whenever they were cooking something.
What are the temperature extremes here, your seasons? You go from
winter, it could get as low as 6-7 degrees. Mm. And then, in the summer, the high 30s.
High 30s.
Right, Jenny?
High 30s is Celsius.
I don't know.
I don't know.
I don't know.
Okay, You guys can convert. Google, just... Are these people who live in the apartments?
No, these are all workers, staff.
Ah.
This is me here.
Cool. Okay, yeah, look at that. That's a cool IT guy. And this traffic, and you're still alive. That's awesome.
Yep.
You must be pretty good. Kids wear uniforms?
Yes.
Hmm?
The principal showing a picture of me from 2001.
I think it's okay that I'm not in there.
Yeah. It's our security team. They keep us safe. But Hong Kong, by nature, is a very safe city.
Mm-hmm. That's what I heard.
Yeah, it's just for a city that's so compact and heavily populated, it's a very...
Why do you think that is?
That's just the nature of the people, I think.
Mm-hmm.
It's a very...
It's got a Royal Canadian Mountie over here. This is heritage, probably.
Yep, yep. Well, all the pictures are of Canada, and then I guess they all come together to form another photo.
Thank you. Now we got some pull-out.
Yeah, this will be more pull-out art in this section. I can't get in there. Oh, this one's open. This is geography. History, I think. Am I right? No, this got to be language arts. This would be grade 8 English.
Hmm.
Grade 8 English. And there's no technology here, because the students all bring their own.
Hmm. Oh, really?
Yeah. It's a one-to-one and a BYOD. So sometimes kids have multiple devices.
So, okay, so... Wait a minute. One-to-one means you supply a device.
No, they all bring in their own laptop.
I see.
A one-to-one laptop. Last year, we used to give every student one.
Now it's part of school.
Yep.
So you say bring in, it doesn't matter what kind.
Yep. And then their other device, whatever.
So it could be a...
Now they're only allowed Lenovo this year.
Huh?
For the laptop, Lenovo laptop. Hmm. And then any other device for their secondary device.
The secondary device can be an iPad?
Yep, could be. Or an Android phone, they're quite popular. Mm-hmm. You can see... We have the raised floors to solve the electrical issue of inherent with technology.
Oh, just getting outlets to all the places.
Yeah.
Uh huh. Yeah. Right there. Cool.
That's grade 8.
Pretty nice. Nice contrast. They have lockers.
Yeah. Let's see if I have access to this room. I do.
This is the other multimedia.
So it's up for replacement this summer, but this is our band room. So the bands, the school bands come in here to record music.
Very cool.
And the record studios behind the glass.
Nice. What do they do with their recordings?
The students take it.
Very cool.
Our English teacher runs this room.
Really?
He's a...
Wow.
That's his passion, music.
Nice job.
Cool. This one was set up for a lunchroom. But this would be...
Ligers.
This is music. This is a brand new music room. The teacher's up to move next year. Can you see if you can get the key for this one? Yep. This is the art room. So see if we can get it there.